It's that time of year that you and I head out to our workshops and we make some gifts for our loved ones. So I've got three simple teardrop trailer gifts ideas for you, and I'm also going to drink some hot chocolate.
I think I drooled some.
Hey campers, Mark here from OverlandTrailer.com. We're going to launch into three gift ideas that can all be made basically from scrap material. The first one we're going to start off with is a classic. If you've been around Overland for any amount of time, you know that in the past we have sold this ornament as a fundraiser for school shop programs and a bunch of other charities. This year we're changing it up and making the CNC files available to you at home, as well as paper templates and plans too. So if you don't own a CNC, you can still make it with standard tools. My thought is that hopefully this could be some sort of family project that you could do with a child or with a spouse or with a random person that you find somewhere. All the links for everything in this whole video is down below. As I mentioned, you don't have to have a CNC to make this ornament, but I'm going to show you the CNC files because the drawings are better than I could show. The first pass with the CNC is just simply running a 60 degree V-bit around to cut out the basic internal shape, and then we run an 1/8 inch bit around the outside to cut the exterior of the teardrop trailer. The wheel is actually just a slice of a 1 inch dowel. Once it's all cut out, then we do some light sanding on it with 200 grit sandpaper. Then we put two holes in it, one at the front that functions as the tongue of the trailer, and one at the top that will function as the hook that it can be hung from. And then apply black to all of the recessed areas of the ornament. Now, if you don't do this with a CNC, obviously these recessed areas are going to be harder to make, but you can still use the template and cut it out and use it basically as a mask for paint. So you can still paint this shape onto the ornament itself. Once the paint has dried, then we go back over with a white paint on a roller to get that done. If you're doing this on a non-CNC version, then you would start with the white and then go to the black. Once the paint has dried, then we apply a little bit of, in this case, I use hot glue. You could also use super glue to apply the wire as well as the wheel. I want to make a polishing wax, and this is something that I've been interested in since watching Lynn over at Darvin Orvar in 2015 render beeswax out and then turn it into a wood finish. Basically, I'm going to do a 4-to-1 ratio of tung oil and beeswax, and we'll melt it all down, pour it into a jar, and then once it has set up in the jar, we'll use it to put on top of all of these gifts that we are finishing, and it gives it a nice soft look and a really great smell. As a side note, Lynn is also building her own teardrop trailer, and you can see some of those videos on her channel as well. I'm very excited about our second gift option because it's brand new. It's something that I just thought up and was looking at our ornament that we did in the first one and thinking, yeah, it's a cool shape, but when you turn it this way, it's too skinny. It doesn't look like a teardrop trailer. So I thought, well, let's make something that's more dimensionally accurate. And so I came up with this. This is something that can be cut out of a piece of 2x4 and some 1/8 inch material that can function as the door, the wheel, and a little license plate on the back. And again, this has the tongue piece on the front. This is very easily done with all hand tools. In our plans, you can find, again, the templates for everything. And I'm also including some CNC files if you want to cut this out, those CNC. To make this, the first thing that I did was to cut out the body shape. And then I went to the 1/8 inch material and cut that out. When everything was cut out, then I went to sanding and sanded off all the burrs from the CNC and just any tooling mark. In this case, I glued it all together with CA glue and then taped it down to hold it in place while it dried. The way it's set up, you can set it on a countertop, or it is light enough, since this is cedar, I could put a hole in the top, a hook, and use it as an ornament as well. For now, we're gonna leave this unfinished because we're going to use our finish that we're cooking up on this and our last gift. Speaking of the last gift, we have a project that is 100% CNC and customizable, which is a camp sign. These make great gifts for not just the holidays, but for birthdays, weddings, and they can be hung inside or outside. And the CNC file that goes with this is 100% customizable. In this case, I'm making this sign for my good old friend, Art Vandelay, who is an importer-exporter that is out of New York. So the first thing I did was I went through my wood pile and I found some cedar planking and I thought this will work great. And I slapped it down and I started the cut. I used the tape and clamp method to keep it down on the table. However, the cedar on the back was so rough that the tape didn't stick very well to the back of the board. And so as the final cut was going through, it just dislodged the board and threw it across the shop, which I can say was a bit of a surprise. So instead of using that cedar plank, I went to a stack of old barnwood that my family's had since the 1980s so that the surface isn't quite as rough, but the surface also had this really great patina that I liked and I thought it would make a great sign. First, I did a roughing pass with a 1/4-inch bit just to knock out some material. Then I came back with a 60-degree V bit and cut in all of the detail of the sign itself, and then followed it up with a 1/4-inch bit that cut out the profile. Now, as far as how to finish this sign, you of course can do it however you want. You could do like we did with the engraved teardrop and just paint everything that's been engraved black and then sand it back and do a natural finish. Since I made this one out of a very old piece of barnwood, I like the patina on it. I'm going to leave it that way. What I'm going to do first though is to knock off some of these sharper edges, and then we're just going to finish it with the finish that we're cooking up. My wax has set up. I have an old t-shirt here. It's going to give the wood a nice sheen, and it kind of brings out more of the color of the patina in this, which I really like. After about 24 hours or so, this particular finish with the tongue oil will develop a sort of a harder surface to it. All right, now if you can see, some of the wax in here has built up in the letters and some of the other little holes and things. So I'm gonna show you how I clear that out. I just use a heat gun for this and I put it on its lowest setting and keep it moving, and that should clear things up pretty good. You can see it liquefy just a little bit. Now, if you're doing fine furniture or something, you probably don't want to hit it with the heat gun. Sign finished. Our teardrops parts, the super glue is dry, so I'm gonna pull everything off. Of course, you can go and do an entire custom paint job for this, doors, wheels, everything. But I'm always partial to the natural wood look, so in this case, I'm just going to finish it with the wax, and then we will put on our tongue so that it sits level. I'm gonna put this on a shelf. So there you have three simple teardrop trailer gifts that you can share with your loved ones this year or do together as a project. It's a lot of fun. If you like these tiny little trailers but want one that's actually a little bit bigger that you can camp in, you might check out this list over here. And I wish you guys a happy Festivus, holidays, Christmas, all that stuff. We'll see you on the other side.